Good morning, Uplift Church 429.
Good morning.
Good morning, good morning. Today is a day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I was glad when I woke up this morning and opened my eyes. I was still on this side of heaven. Hallelujah. Although I don't want to say that I wouldn't be glad to see my Heavenly Father, but I'm just not ready to see Him quite yet. Hallelujah. So I'm thanking Him. Thanking Him. Hallelujah. With all that is in me, that He thought it not robbery to give me one more opportunity to lift His name in praise. So I'm asking everyone who can, please stand with me as we give the Lord a hand clap of praise and let Him know that we love Him. Let Him know that He's deserving, hallelujah, of all the praise and all the worship, because everything that He did for us, He did for us out of love. He didn't have to do it, but He did it anyway.
Thank you, Lord.
Dear Heavenly Father, we welcome Your holy presence into this place today. We enter into Your gates with thanksgiving and into Your courts with praise. We come united as one body, serving and worshiping the true and living God. We honor Your name today, El Elyon, the Most High God, El Shaddai, God Almighty, the source of our blessings, Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Hallelujah. Jehovah Nisi, our victor. Jehovah Shalom, our peace. Jehovah Shammah, our companion. Jehovah Rahi, our shepherd. Father, we thank You for Jesus, our Messiah, Lord and Savior. Thank You, Father, for His precious blood, which He shed on Calvary to give us eternal life and declare us the righteousness of Almighty God. We thank You, Father, for Your Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost that lives in us and upon us. Father, we thank You that it gives us power, might, ability, and authority. Your Holy Spirit is our comforter, our intercessor, our counselor, our helper, our strengthener, our standby, and our advocate. We confess and believe that we live and walk by faith and not by sight. We can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens us. We are here today because You have purpose for us, things that we are going to do as individuals and in the body of Christ. We pray for those who are in the hospital, the rehab facilities, and the nursing homes, that Your healing power is manifesting in them today and every day. We pray for those who are in the jails and prisons, and we pray that You will set those who are truly innocent free. Your praise is flowing throughout the jails and prisons. Father, we glorify You for Uplift Church 429, a ministry. For the work of the ministry. Clothe the naked, house the homeless, and feed the hungry. Father, we thank You for the people You're sending from the north, south, east, and west to help build up Uplift Church 429 and the kingdom of God on this earth. We praise You for the worship facility and our future worship facility. We thank You, Father, for Your grace, divine favor, that covers Uplift Church 429. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank You, Father, for the vision that You sent our pastors. For the Spirit of the Lord will rest upon them. May the Spirit of wisdom, understanding, revelation, knowledge, and the fear of the Lord guide them. We pray that You will continue to protect them in all that they do, and provide for their needs according to Your riches and glory. We declare divine health and healing, spiritual discernment, and Your grace rest on our pastors. Father, we thank You for satisfying them with long, prosperous lives. May their lives be blessed with peace, love, joy, favor, and financial prosperity. May the anointing and blessings on our pastors flow throughout the body of believers here at Uplift Church 429. In Jesus' mighty name, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for the shepherds that you sent to watch over your flock. Thank you, Father, for giving them wisdom and discernment to continue to lead, guide, and direct in a path that you would have us to travel. Father, thank you for giving them the ability to be able to see that it is your will that shall be done. Hallelujah. And as long as we walk the path that you have us on, as long as we keep our eyes on you, Jesus, hallelujah, there is nothing beyond our grasp. We thank you, Father, for giving us the ability to know that as long as we believe in you and have faith the size of a mustard seed, hallelujah, there is no limits. We are limitless to the things that we can accomplish. Hallelujah. There are no boundaries. Hallelujah. Uplift Church, this is your year. Hallelujah. This is our year. Our year of prosperity. Our year of overflow. We are more than conquerors through the body of Christ. Hallelujah. We're going to do some confessions. Hallelujah. God knows our thoughts. And we always say that he knows our heart. But sometimes he wants to hear it out your mouth. So this morning we're going to do some confessions, and we're going to confess those things that we are thinking. We're going to speak them into existence. Sometimes you have to say things out loud so that you hear it and your mind believes it. Hallelujah. We got to speak it into existence. Put it in the atmosphere. Hallelujah. You never know who's listening. So we're going to speak it into existence today. We celebrated with my mother yesterday, her 75th birthday. Yes, hallelujah. I tell you, she, in 2014, she had a massive stroke that paralyzed her on her left side. But when I tell you it ain't did nothing to her faith, and it ain't did nothing to her tongue, hallelujah. She still talk trash every day. She still talk about who she'll put on the floor. Hallelujah. But I thank God. She doesn't see herself as having limits and bounds. So I thank God for his continued blessings upon her. All right, I want everybody to repeat after me, please. Father, I declare that you are able to do exceeding abundantly above all I ask, think, or imagine, according to the power of your word working in me. I believe that you sent Jesus so that I will have life and enjoy my life in abundance till it overflows. I speak words that give life to others and myself. I speak words and uplift. My words never tear down, destroy, or discourage. No foul, polluted, or corrupt language comes out of my mouth. My life is a reflection of God, his word, and his spirit working in me. I am a new creature created in Christ Jesus, and I live a renewed life. I can do what God has created according to
his riches in glory.
Anything that I ask of the Father, in Jesus' name, it is done for me. I live and walk by faith and not by sight. My God has given me a measure of faith, and my faith moves mountains. My faith moves mountains. I have faith, confident expectation in God's power and ability to change my life. In Jesus' name. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for being a God that is able, that has never left us nor forsaken us.
Thank you, Lord.
Holy Spirit. Let the children say, Holy Spirit, activate. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
We're going to touch the hem of his garment.
Glory to you.
For just a few of the things. I don't know if y'all want them, but I want them.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
So we're going to reach up and touch the hem of his garment. And I want everybody to reach up with me. And we're going to pull down some of these things that we know God is able to do.
Father,
I touch the hem of your garment. And I pull down. Joy. In Jesus' name. Pull it down.
Woo.
Yes, Lord. You gotta pull it down like you mean it. Like you on that slot machine and you done been there for a couple of hours and you know this time is the time you gonna get that reward. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We're gonna reach up one more time.
Father.
I touch the hem of your garment,
and I pull down
unlimitless favor. In Jesus' name. Pull it down.
Woo.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you, Father, for that favor that you keep bringing around us. You keep sending to look for us. You keep telling it, run them down. Get all over them. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. And we praise your holy name. You are more than worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Good morning. Hallelujah. Give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Thank him for that favor this morning. Thank him for that love this morning. Hallelujah. Look around and tell somebody, say, neighbor, you look good. You look blessed. And I see God's blessing and favor all over you in Jesus' name. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. You know, I always say you got to keep a scripture and a song in your heart. Because you never know when you're going to need to call upon it. And this morning, I'm in the house and I'm singing this song. It's an old song. But it's just doing my heart some good. And I want y'all to sing it with me if y'all know it this morning. Kill the music for me. It's an old song. It's a simple song. And it simply goes like this. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Sing it again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Someone thank you. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. So good. You've been so good. Yes, he has. You've been so good. You've been stanza just one more time. Just one more time. I just want to tell him thank you. See, it's Father's Day. And I want to celebrate the Father. Before I go into another one of my old songs, because I'm just going back in my library. Those songs that keep me and still keeping me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. He's a way maker. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's a stone tower. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Good morning again. Uplift Church 429. Hallelujah. Well, I tell you, my pastor is a man of many talents. We going to have to see if we can get him an audition on America's Got Talent or something. Oh, he want to be shy now. Well, good morning again, Uplift Church. Y'all know the announcements are the entertaining part of the service. We want to welcome each and every one of you who joined us this morning, whether you're here in the sanctuary or you're on Facebook Live. We want to tell you that here at Uplift Church 429, we are here to walk the journey with you as you are traveling and looking for God's plan and purpose in your life. Know that we will be right here with you to help you, guide you, and to welcome you into the kingdom. We want to remind each and every one of you that Facebook Live prayer will be Monday through Thursday at 7 o'clock a.m. Pastor James is on each morning at 7 o'clock a.m. only Monday through Thursday. I know some of you have been on looking for prayer on Friday, but during the summer months, he is taking a short break. He's trying to rest up and get prepared for our trip to the Dominican, because he has a lot that he's going to have to do. So he's taking a little break on Fridays. So if you have been looking on Facebook Live on Fridays for prayer, you can go to our YouTube page. All of the prayers are rebroadcasted. So if there's prayers that you may have missed, you can go to the YouTube page on Fridays and pull up the Uplift Church 429 YouTube page, and any prayer or service can be rebroadcasted right there. Wednesday evenings is Bible study. Brain Change Bible Study with Pastor James, Pastor Sabrina, and Pastor Angela. I say every Sunday, this is not your grandma's Bible study. This is a Bible study that takes God's word and teaches it so that you can apply it to our lives, today's everyday life. So on Wednesday evenings at 7 o'clock p.m., make sure that you log back on to the Uplift Church 429 Facebook page and join them for Bible study. There is no worship service on next Sunday, June 26th. No worship service next Sunday, June 26th. All services and prayers, again, are rebroadcasted on our Uplift Church 429's YouTube page. Any and all financial donations can be made by Zelle at 561-985-1781 or using the Tithely app. That's T-I-T-H-E.L-Y. You can download this app. It's free in your Google Play Store or your Apple Store. Again, that's 561-985-1781 for all financial donations, either using Zelle or the Tithely app. If you are in need of prayer, please contact the church. You can call at 561-985-1781 or email using upliftchurch429@gmail.com. All prayer requests are answered. Please mark your calendars and make plans to attend the Family Fun Day on July 2nd at 11 o'clock a.m. The location is Dyer Park in West Palm Beach. Please use the north entrance. That is going to be a day of tremendous fun. It's going to be fabulous food, because my husband is going to be on the grill, baby. And there is none other. He is the true grill master.
Yes, he is.
And pastor. is going to be iced. Him and his ice cold brothers of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. I told you, I'm saving my time and using my time to ice the alphas. And that's going to be a bonus. I hope we get our bonus check. That means I get more time. Yeah, so please, $5 a budget. Oh, if there are any former students of Officer James Wilkerson that would like revenge and like to ice him because of, any little incident that might have happened, please feel free to join us by sending your $5 to ICE, the pastor. All donations go to our benevolence ministry. Remember, that's for the kids. We want to make sure we can provide for every child's need. So we need lots of buckets, lots and lots of buckets. And don't just send no donation. Come on, I don't want to ice the pastor. I just want to give a donation. No, 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 no. We want to ice the pastor. The pastor wants to be iced. He wants to be iced because he wants to make sure that he proves how ice cold he really is. He's that 06, y'all. So at least 6 buckets per person is, that's what I'm saying. Like, I think to, mesh it all together with his alpha thing. So 1906. So at least 6 buckets should be the minimum that I'm asking for every person that I'm contacting to give. That's a $30 donation. Every fourth Sunday, we ask that you give an additional $22 toward the benevolence fund. I'm just asking that you add another 8 to it. Get these 6 ice buckets for the 06 man.
Wait, what was your number? What your number 6? What's your number 6?
Eight. Oh, his number. Hey, his number was 8 online. So if you want to do 8 buckets, that's good too. I might do 8 times 8. He too cold. So again, make sure you mark your calendars. July 2nd, 11 o'clock a.m., Family Fun Day. We're going to have food. We're going to have games. We're going to have fishing. It's going to be a day where you get an opportunity to see that being a Christian doesn't mean that you got to be stale. It doesn't mean that you got to not walk around and talk to people. We're going to be showing people God's love and how God works in your life. Come out, have some fun, spend some time with some good people, fellowship and commune. It's going to be a day that you will always remember. Again, buckets, $5. I'm seeing if I can come up with a bundle pack. I'll make that announcement next Sunday. I'm going to try to see if I can work out a bundle packet on these ice buckets. Again, we want to thank each and every one of you who joined us today. We want to thank you if you're here in the sanctuary. We want to thank you if you're on Facebook Live. We want to make sure that we let everyone know that here in Uplift Church 429, we still practice CDC guidelines for COVID. We are still wearing masks if you choose to. We still socially distance. We sanitize at the hands at the door and take temperatures. We want to make you feel safe and comfortable so that you come back into the sanctuary. Amen. We love you that join us on Facebook Live, but there is nothing like being in the building. Yes. So please contact someone that you know might need just a little bit of spiritual lift. Invite them to church. Even if it is on Facebook Live, any and all other announcements will come from our pastors. Mm.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Yeah, looking forward to July 2nd. That is our church service for that weekend. You know, what can I say? Yes, I'm excited. Y'all know the whole time, Sister Tonya talking about the family fund down the park. My wife's sitting over there talking about, I got my money. I guess she don't see me as a husband that day. She sees me as, oh, I get to ice the pastor.
Oh, no, I see you as my husband. It's just some things that I want to ice you about.
I just feel the love of all them buggies. But listen, it is for a great cause. That's why I do it. And, you know, but I just want you to come out and just have a good time. Let's just celebrate, you know, family. And if you need prayer, we'll pray for you at the park. Pray for you wherever you are, you know. Hey, you want to give your life to Jesus? But I'm asking everybody to please be in attendance, to please bring your family and your friends out, because some of them may need to see Jesus too. You know, we don't always have to be in the building to show somebody the love of Jesus Christ.
We are the church.
And last year, we were told by some matriarchs, last year we raised over $800 doing Ice the Pastor, I believe.
Amen.
Yes. Oh Lord, so Tony just said our goal is 2,000. Y'all give that after the second, starting on the third. But last year, you know, two matriarchs got me and they were telling me about the food. So I said, you know what, we're gonna step our game up this year. You know, we're gonna have some good food and just have a good time. Said they were looking for the ribs and the chicken, which we had none. But this year, the birds dying and the pigs are fully committed, both of them. So therefore, we're gonna have a great time. Just looking forward to having a good time starting at 11 a.m. And the reason you're gonna come in the north entrance is the quickest way to get to the pavilion, but also because of the road construction. They may be finished, but use the north entrance. So make preparations to come out and join us. That day. Hallelujah. Amen. I'll tell you, I don't even want to add this morning. All right. With that being said, I do want to say one thing this morning. Oh, yes, we are having communion before the word. So get your communion together so that before I bring the message, we're going to have communion this morning. But I do want to just say one thing for those. I don't know if y'all picked up on Sister Tonya when she was saying we're gonna reach up and touch the hem of his garment. She pulled that thing down, she had that leg up. She was pulling. I thought at one point she gonna go back like the drum majors doing, just put her head and just pull it all down this morning. But praise the Lord, hallelujah. Thank you everybody for coming out. And once again, we wanna say happy Father's Day to all the fathers and happy Juneteenth to all of the black people in America. Hallelujah. So praise the Lord and God bless you. Let's prepare. And especially for those that, yes, who sacrifice so that we can enjoy the freedoms that we enjoy. Hallelujah. So let's prepare for our offering. God bless you this morning. Hallelujah. No, let's prepare for our offering. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord today. This is the day that the Lord has made. I am rejoicing. I am glad in it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Make it a wall.
this might be the envelope this morning. Everybody has one that wants one, needs one. Hallelujah. Yes. Say this after me. Say, Father, I thank you
for this offering.
You have blessed me to be a blessing. I give.
It's
given back to me. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Well, what measure I meet is measured back to me. Money, go, grow, multiply. We'll see you again. In Jesus' name. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. Remember, if you're to my left, you can come bring your money up here, your envelope. To my right, you can place it over here. Every time I turn around,
when will he come through every time? When will he come through every time?
Yeah.
When will he come through every time?
When will he come through every time?
Every time I turn around, he's taking it away.
Yeah, turn around one time.
Every time I turn around,
give God some praise. Hallelujah.
Let me ask you again.
Yeah. Praise Him. Praise Him. All right, y'all. Before we go into communion, I ask Deacon Harvey just to come say a few words of encouragement about fathers. And right after that, we're going to have communion. And then we're going into the Word. Praise the Lord. All right, let's give God a hand clap of praise that He comes forth this morning.
Good morning, Uplift Church 429.
Good morning.
I want to say again, happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Just a little encouragement. We know fathers to be the backbone of their families. They work hard, they take care of their families, and they do what they have to do. But we also need them to understand that they have a soul that requires them to seek out Jesus. You know, they work hard and they figure that church is for women and the children. But church is also for you too, fathers. Jesus loves you as just as much as he loved the women and the children. So you need rest for your soul. You need to be rejuvenated. You need to be reinvigorated. You need Jesus. All right? So fathers, in your business and in your time of taking care of your families and doing what you do as a man of the house, please seek Jesus.
Amen.
Add some Jesus to your life. Amen.
Amen.
As for the Elijah that stands on this mountain, I am your Elijah. July the 2nd, if they mess with you, they got to mess with me. All right? So I'm gonna stand by you. You my pastor. I'm gonna stand with you. All right. So if they mess with you, they gotta mess with me. All right.
Praise the Lord. Boy, I tell you, thank you, Nigga Harvey. And look, they already talking about. Okay, he can get some too. That's all right. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He ain't scared.
I heard somebody say, I got six buckets for him.
They say they got six buckets for him. I just want to thank the Lord this morning. See, laughter does good like a medicine. Some people feel like, you know what, you can't do this in church, you can't laugh in church. Boy, I wish they would just take that spiritual laxative and clean themselves out. Get that hell and frustration out of them, all them rules. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Get all that stuff out you. You need the Lord and you need to laugh. So come on out, have a good time with us. Amen. Amen. All right, y'all. Let's prepare for communion. If you're at home watching, get your elements ready. Get you something to drink and some bread or some crackers. If you ain't got that, get you a cookie or something. Let's just have communion this morning. Praise the Lord. Lee, listen, y'all, my wife whispering or saying low, she's talking about our son one Sunday. He ain't have no bread or nothing. He had a gummy bears and juice. And that's what he had. He was watching online. He said, that's all I got. Oh, my God. Praise the Lord. Bow your heads. Let me pray first. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We come before you this morning. Father, we thank you for sending your only begotten son to die for us, to be the final atonement for our sins, God, to put us in right standing with you. And Father, as we take now this time to commune, to just show our gratitude, to remember him, we ask that you continue to keep us, guide us, and direct us. In Jesus' most precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
On the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread and he broke it. He said, this bread represents my body, which is broken for you. His body was broken for us, for our healing, for our deliverance, for our salvation. He was wounded. He was bruised. He was chastised so that we wouldn't have to be. He says, often as you do this, no matter whether you think you're perfect or you're imperfect, he said, just remember me. Take, eat. After the same manner, he took the cup. He said, this cup represents the blood, represents my blood, which is shed for the remissions of sins of many. His blood was shed so that when God see us, he see us through the blood. He sees us through what his son did. He knows we need a savior. That's why he sent Jesus for the forgiveness of our sin. Jesus says, often as you do this, I know you're not perfect. I know you're not right. But remember me. Take, drink. I know it was the blood. I know. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bow your heads. Let us pray. Let us move into the word. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this day. First of all, we just say happy Father's Day to you. For this is the day that you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Every day is Father's Day. It belongs to you, Father. But Lord God, I come right now to humble myself under your hand, to humble myself in your presence, that you increase as I decrease, all of you and none of me. Father God, I ask right now that you anoint my mind, my tongue to speak the words that you will have me to speak. I pray, oh Heavenly Father, that every eye will be open to show us what the word will speak to us. Every heart will be prepared like that of a good soil, ready to receive a seed of the word. That seed will be planted, rooted, and grounded. That seed will produce, hallelujah, fruit and harvest that will last from one generation to the next. And now, Father, I just thank you that every ear has been anointed to hear clearly from you this morning. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. You have your Bibles, even if you don't act like you got a Bible in your hand, ain't no way. You lift up your phone if you got your Bible on that. Say this after me. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I am what it says I am.
I am what it says I
can do what it says I can do.
I have what it says I can have.
I declare my Bible is the living word of my living God. It has the power and the authority to change my life. And I declare, after hearing the word, my life will be changed for the better in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm just truly grateful to be here today. I'm truly grateful for my father. Hallelujah. For the relationship that we have built over these past years. Much better, much stronger than it was when I was a child. But I'm thankful to God, because if it wasn't for my father, I wouldn't be standing here today. A lot of times I think in life we expect our fathers to be perfect, forgetting that they're only humans, made of flesh and blood, and that they learn things that they teach us. May not have been the best father, but it's the best father we ever had. And we ought to thank God for that, because your father had a purpose. And one of the purposes that your father had was to get you here. Because if it wasn't for sperm and egg getting together, you wouldn't be here today. You know, you wouldn't be here. But when I was thinking about fathers and reading the word, go with me to Psalms 103. Book of Psalms, verses 103. Go down to verse number 13. Psalms 103:13. It reads like this from the King James. It says, like as a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. Another translation says, like a father has compassion for his children, so does the Lord has compassion for those who reverence him. You know, this Father's Day, it's also Juneteenth as well. But I want to talk a little bit about fathers. Because I too am a father. Not perfect. Made some mistakes, still making mistakes. Sometimes I could be a little rough. Sometimes I could be very loving. But yet and still, I'm still a father. And I still have a responsibility to the two sons who came from my loins. And that is to try to be the best father that I could be. Regardless of what's in my past, I now know that I need to be a father according to the word of God. Amen. I need to have compassion for my children, including my goddaughter. I need to have compassion for them. I need to show them love at all times. Whether I'm happy with them or upset with them, I still have a job to fulfill as being a father. I still have a role to play in their lives. And do they do everything that I want them to do the way I want them to do it? No. I didn't do everything the way my parents wanted me to do it. I went against the rules sometime. I paid for it too, but yet and still, I did it. There was a voice telling me, don't do that. But you know, when you're young, you're not listening to them voices. And a couple of times, my father, he reminded me of why I shouldn't do that. Back then, I was mad. But now I understand that was love. Discipline is a part of being a father. Amen. It's part of raising children, disciplining them, not killing them, cussing them out. But sometimes you may put them on punishment. That may not work. So sometimes you may have to use a belt or something, you know, to just reinforce what you're teaching them. Because as a father, I want to kind of break, well, first of all, what is a father? Because sometimes I hear single parents, single mothers say, I'm mama and daddy. Thank God you're not mother and father. Because a father is a male parent. Yeah, you may be the only one there taking care of the child, but you can only be the mother. You cannot be the mother and the father. See, because a father has been programmed with some things that a mother has not been programmed with. A father understands some things that a mother never will. A father will let a child fall, be right there, and encourage them to get back up. Anybody saw the president fall off his bike yesterday? What did he do? He got back up, right? Why'd he get back up? Probably because his father let him fall and said, now, boy, get your behind up. Try it again. Come on, let's go. A father, when he loves his children, he'll let them fall, but he'll be right there to encourage them to get back up. Some mothers will do it too, but we're talking about father. A father is a man who has begotten a child or children. Came out of his mom. It is so sad that some children can't even have a relationship with their father. Can't have one for crazy reasons. But if you are blessed to be a father, and as a man, you still can be in your children's lives, appreciate that. Appreciate the fact that you get to play your part that God ordained you and called you to do in your children's lives. To do what? Let's go down the list. As a father, I find it that the F in father, a father, a male who has begotten children, that F, there should nothing be above a father's faith in God and his family. Number one on my list is God. Number two is my family. Number three is church. Why? Because if I got to walk away from the church, but never walking away from God, to keep my family intact, I got to do what I got to do. But my family, my sons, they was raised in church. And they know, hey, church is most important in dad's life. His faith in God, my belief in God. So as a father, our faith in God, our relationship with God, our reverence for God should be the highest thing in our lives. And that should be the thing that our children see. And loving our families, when it comes to this world, nothing should be above family. Meeting the needs of a family. Nothing in a father's life is more important than his faith in God and his family. If there's anything else above those two, something is wrong. Something is wrong. The A father, he accepts his responsibilities of fatherhood. He accepts the challenges that he may face in raising his children. But he accepts that knowing that at the end, I'm still pleasing God. I didn't know anything about raising children. I didn't. There was no book. Well, people had wrote some books, but all that stuff, nah. Because some of the stuff they was telling you to do is the reason why we have some of these young people doing the things they're doing now. Going to buy guns and walking into a school killing people. See, a father accepts the responsibility and the challenges of teaching his children to be respectful, to be mannerable, to be loving, to be kind, to be gentle, to never give up, to keep on trying, even when it gets hard. As a spiritual father, I had to accept the responsibility of doing what? Teaching God's his children. Loving you, trying to encourage you. Because sometimes it does get rough. I remember the other day we were in the gym working out, and I walked by Sister Sam. She was on the machine, and I just walked by and said, "Don't give up, keep going." She said, "Thank you, Pastor, for the encouragement." And I said, "You encouraging me to keep going too." Hallelujah. We have to encourage one another. Children sometimes have to encourage their fathers. Just tell them thank you. You know, we have to accept the responsibility of teaching our children what love is. And sometimes you as a father may not have been taught some things in life, but one of my greatest things was I wanted to be better than my father. My father made sure my brother and I had. He did that. I know my father would steal some bills to make sure we had. Y'all laughing, I'm serious. My father would take us to a place, it would just be my father, Corey, and I. He said, "Come on." We ride to West Palm Beach, go to the Palm Beach Mall that is no longer there, and he'd take us to this soup store called Boys Town. He'd go in there, he'd get us soups to make sure, hey, you going to church, you're going to look good. He made sure. He left my mama wherever she was at the house, whatever. He said, "Come on, I'm taking my boys. We going somewhere." I remember going fishing with him and my uncles and stuff like that. I remember him tossing me a football. I also remember the time I was doing terrible in the class and I'm sitting down at the table and he walked by. He looked. He said, "What you doing?" I said, "I'm doing geometry, which I don't understand." He said, "Let me show you." He did this. He did this. He did this. That's your answer. And walked out the door. And then I went to the back of the book. I said, "Man, that's right." I said, "He is smart." I'm just saying. That's what I'm saying. A father has another role. He's a teacher. He's a teacher. He's a trainer. He's an educator. You know, one thing I got on my son's nerve with is telling them they had to open the door for their mama. Before they got there, I was opening the door, and after they left, I was gonna be opening the door. So I trained them. You open the door for women. You let them walk through first. You open the car door for them. Show them how to open the car door so that if a woman had on a short dress, you turn your back until she gets in the car, and you close the door, then you walk to your door to get in. I had to teach them some tough love sometimes. And I do have one of my sons, oh my God, he is a direct reflection of me. Sometimes he gets on my nerves. Whew, the oldest one. Sometimes we go word for word, but I have to let him know, son, I'm still your father. He come home, he decides that he gonna learn some new stuff, he wanna try me, so I have to let him know I still put you on the ground. Teaching him, "Son, I never taught you everything I knew. I still keep some tricks that I never taught you." I still have to talk to him, even when he don't want to listen. And sometimes it frustrates me as a father, just like a teacher in a classroom. You've been teaching, and you can't understand why these children not getting it. You don't broke it down to the simplest form, and they still don't understand. Well, as a father, sometimes it's the same way. How many times I got to keep telling you the same thing? Well, Proverbs 22:6 tells us, fathers, train up a child in the way that they should go. He didn't say train on one time. He said training. We know training takes place all the time. I never forget when I was a police officer, I used to get tired of going to training sometime. Man, how many times we got to do this? We did this last year. We did it the year before. But then a couple times it came to where I needed that training, and thank God we had the training over and over again. So as a father, sometimes you got to keep training your children in the same thing that you thought they learned. They didn't learn. But it's up to us to keep training and to keep teaching. You know, fathers, we need to teach our children what love is. And if we don't know, we need to find out what it is so we can teach our children. When I do see my sons, I always give them a hug. I always tell them I love them. Somebody can say, well, man, I don't want no man hugging me. That's punk stuff. Or call me a punk because I'm going to hug my son every time I see him because I don't know. That may be the last time I see him. Or it may be the last time they see me. And I'm going to tell them that I love them. Even when I talk to my father, I tell my father, I love you. I appreciate you. Thank you. Because he's given me some words, especially in the past 12 years, to help me out. Actually, longer than that, 15, to help me out as being a pastor, to teach me some things and show me some things and talk to me about some things. And I thank God for that. Say, he's not perfect. I'm not perfect. His father wasn't perfect. His father's father wasn't perfect. We're not perfect. We're just one. And we have to leave room for growth as teachers. Teachers look for growth. As a father, look for growth in your children and appreciate that growth that they have. Some things they're going to do just like you. And when they do, don't get upset with them. Understand, they're imitating you. They're doing what they see you do. That's all. If you fight and the children fight, they seeing you fight, so they think, okay, my dad will fight, I'm supposed to fight too. Why? We're training. The H, hospital. Fathers should be hospitable. What I mean? Loving. We as fathers should express love. If you're married to your wife in front of your children, express love to your children. Show them appreciation. Tell your children thank you sometime. Do something nice for your children sometime. Basically, be hospitable to your children. See, I'm going to say something. If I can't say nothing good to my own son, to my goddaughter, to my wife, to my two grandsons, then I shouldn't come up in here and be saying good things to you all. Because that's wrong. Thank you. Yes, charity begins at home. Sometimes I just send my sons and my goddaughter a message just to tell them, hey, I appreciate you. I love you. I'm proud of you. And they ain't did nothing. They haven't said anything. But I just want to send them that so that they'll know I love you. They can look back and read it and just say thank you. Sometimes they'll respond. Sometimes I get a phone call. Sometimes I get a text message back saying, I needed to hear that right then. Why? Because they need love. I don't care if they 85. I don't care if they 55. If you and your child are still alive, they still need to hear you tell them, I love you. Yeah. A word of encouragement from a father goes a long way. And little children long to be with who? They daddy, their fathers, teenagers. We all long to hear our fathers say good words to us, to say good things about us. We reminisce on some times that we spent with our fathers, and that's why it's so important for us as fathers to show our children love. And not just any kind of love. Show them the godly kind of love, that unconditional love, the kind of love that says, you know what? You messed up. You got to pay for it. But I want you to know, I still love you. Amen. I'm still here for you. I appreciate you. Because they're the next generation to carry on your legacy. And depending on what you do with them will depend on what kind of legacy you leave. It is so sad that some children stop talking to their fathers because of the way that they treated them as a child. Father died. And they don't feel no remorse. They say he wasn't a good father. No way. He wasn't even a good man. Didn't even go to the funeral. That's sad. That's not the kind of legacy we want to leave to our children. The Bible tells us in my favorite scripture, out of all 66 of the books of the Bible, this is my favorite scripture. A good man, Proverbs 13:22, a good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children. That's talking about wisdom. That's talking about knowledge. It's talking about love. That's talking about finances. A good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children. Fathers, what are you leaving to your children? What will they say about you when you're gone? Will they say, my dad, even though he wasn't perfect, I knew he loved me. He taught me how to do this. He showed me this. He talked to me about this. Be hospitable. The E and father, be an example. Set the standard for your children to follow. When I talk to my children, especially my oldest son, because he's intelligent. And I told him throughout his years, age for age, you're smarter than me when I was your age. I told him, I said, but one thing I recognize about you, you just like me when I was your age. I was talking to him about a class he was taking recently, he just completed yesterday. And I was telling him throughout, I said, son, you know you're better than that. I said, you know you could do much better. He said, listen, dad, this is a pass or fail class. He told his mama, he said, you know, I got to find something more challenging because that class I didn't have to study for. He said, I got to go back to school and finish my degree. But I always tried to tell him, son, you are very intelligent. Stop being so lazy. Stop doing just enough to get by. And he started to realize the words that I was telling him because this, he said, it's just too easy. Where other people failed out of the class, he still excelled. Even when they sent him to his first training class after he got out of boot camp, he said it was hard, but I made it. Out of 15 of us, only 7 graduated. I said, yeah, it's the second hardest class in the U.S. Navy or school behind Navy SEALs. It's number 2 with the highest dropout rate. I said, I always told you, son, you are intelligent. You're smarter than I was at your age. I said, but you got some stuff you got to get out of you. He made me feel real good yesterday when he called and told me he going to pay for something. I was like, what? He said, yeah, I'll just give you the money when I get home or else I'll sell it to you. I said, well, whatever you want to do, just sell me the money and I'm going to do what I got to do. So I look up at my phone, sure enough. I said, Lord, what's going on? But I got to send him a text today and said, oh, that's not my Father's Day gift, just to let you know. Because I know him. Father, set the standard for your children. I always tell fathers this, if you got a daughter, date your daughter. Not in that kind of sense, but teach your daughter how a man is supposed to treat her. Teach your sons how to treat a woman. Show them through their mother. Put your arms around their mom and then put your arms around them and tell them that you love them. So especially with your daughter, so that when some knucklehead walk up to them and try to spit some foolish games, while he talking about, you know, ooh, yeah, you know, I can do this. I said, they can say, excuse me. My daddy did that. You got to rise above that.
Amen.
You know, they talking about taking you to Red Lobster and you say, that's like Burger King to me. I don't go there. Not teaching them to be bougie, but have some standards. Because daughters need their fathers in their lives to show them how a man is supposed to treat them. Sons need fathers in their lives so that they know what it's like to be a man when they get older. When hey, they start dating a woman and they get married, teach your son not to violate. Teach your son how to be gentle. Because as we look around, we see that is being lost today. That's being lost. And if you don't believe me, just go on YouTube. Go on TikTok. Go on Instagram, Twitter. And you ask yourself, I ask myself, where were the fathers? Who's teaching? Who's training? I was telling Mariah today, the young usher, I said, you're so beautiful. I told her, I said, when I see you from now on, and I say, how are you doing? Who is Mariah? I said, I want you to tell me about you. Say, I am beautiful. I am bold. I am blessed. I am a child of God. I said, yes, because you are beautiful.
Amen.
You are beautiful. We have to encourage them. I talked to Jeremiah first. Just wanted to let him know, hey, I love you. God bless you. Why are you looking like that today? I'm not their father, but I want to set an example of what a man is in their life.
Amen.
That's all. To encourage. Sister Tanya mentioned me being a police officer. And when I worked at Royal Palm Beach High School, there were some girls who came in and they called me dad. And I asked myself why. I said, because you act just like my daddy. You won't let me get away with nothing. You always telling me stuff for good. And if you see me with a boy and you know he ain't no good, you're going to pull me aside and let me know. That's right.
Yeah.
Clank, clank. Lock it all down until you get married. He ain't no good. He was just over there talking to another girl. I'm just saying. We're called to be that example because somebody may not have had it.
Yes.
And the last thing about a father. Be a role model. Show them the way. So that when they talk about, name a role model in your life, my father was the greatest example of what a hero or what a role model is. Not was, but is. Even if he dead and gone, he's still my role model. He set the way for me so that I'll know what to do. There is no Superman, ain't got nothing on my dad, ain't got nothing on my father. He fictional, but my father was a real hero. My father, he is a true role model. He always encouraged me. He always told me, good or bad, the things I needed to do. He was always there to encourage me, whether it was a challenge I was facing or something I was trying to do or wanted to do. My father showed me. Sometimes he told me no, but now I understand why. My father is my greatest hero. And I want to do my best to be better to my children than my father was to me. So, fathers, thank you for your dedication to God and your family. Thank you for being that light for others to follow. Thank you, Father. And I just want to encourage all fathers. If you see your children today, when you see your children today, put your arms around them, tell them you love them, and you appreciate God for them. Or if you can't, because I won't see mine, but I'm going to send them a text and say, hey, I love you. But let them know that you appreciate them for being the best child you ever had. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bow your heads, let's go. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come, we thank you, we praise you today. We give you glory and honor, we esteem you high. Father, I thank you for each and every father that's listening, who will listen. I thank you for those who are not afraid to step up to the plate and be the man, be the father that you called them to be. Father God, even though we struggle, we ask for your help in continuing us to be the role model, to be the man of God that you called us to be, to set the example, to set the standard for children and children's children to follow God. We thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. To all fathers in the building, I ask you to stand right where you are, y'all. Stretch your hands toward them while I say a prayer over our fathers today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you at home as a father, you stand as I stretch my hand as we pray over you today. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning on the behalf of fathers. Ask that your kingdom come, your will be done in their lives as planned and the will of God is in heaven. Father, we ask for your steadfast protection all over them. Lord God, we ask you to guide them in their thoughts and be with them in their walk with you. Father, help them to continue to be the men of God that you called them to be the example, to be the light for others who follow after them, who look up to them. And Father, thank you for the rich reward that you have set in their honor, Father, that you have for them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Bow your heads this morning. Let me do this invitation. Is there another mic on? Hallelujah. All right. Bow your heads. Just say this after me. Say, Father.
Father.
I believe in my heart. And confess with my mouth
that
you sent Jesus
to die for me.
His blood was shed
for the forgiveness
of my sin. And I thank you
that
my sins,
my
shortcomings,
my
shortfalls
are forgiven.
As a father,
you love me.
And have compassion
for me
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. If you're watching online, you say that now, just get in church. Know that God loves you. Hey, man of God, man of valor, continue to be the man that God called you to be. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet with me this morning. Hallelujah. Let's get ready. Let's dismiss. Hallelujah. Don't forget, have prayer in the morning at 7 a.m. We will not be having prayer this Thursday morning, but keep us, hallelujah, in your prayers. So we will be having prayer Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Bible study Wednesday night. So I want to just thank y'all, and no service on Sunday. Join us July 2nd at that Dyer Park at 11 a.m. for a great time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now let me do this benediction. Hallelujah. Close your eyes, all heads bowed. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you right now. On the behalf of these, your people, your children, your sons, and your daughters. Father, as we depart this place, but never your presence, may your grace and favor always be upon us. Father, thank you for the hedge of protection, for being our shield and our buckler, our stone tower today. Lord God, I ask you to watch over them and keep them. And Father, in everything we do, may it be to please you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen. Now, on the behalf of myself, James Tiger Wilkerson, the senior pastor of Uplift Church 429, my beautiful wife, Pastor Sabrina, our family team, Wilkerson, and the most beautiful, is anointed, bestest, blessedest, Holy Ghost filled, amazing, devil stuffing, fire belt ties, committed, skillful, lawyer, able, prompt to do, on fire, body of believers on this side of heaven, our Uplift Church 429 family, and our Uplift Church Facebook Live family. God bless you. We love you. See you in the morning. Peace. Have a great day, everybody. We are dismissed.